What's happening, Boulevard family? I'm Jeremy Pierre. This is your video announcements. We need you to pay very close attention to stay up on what's happening here at the Boulevard. Let's get it. If you are a registered voter and do not wish to vote in person due to the COVID-19 situation, you are eligible to request an absentee ballot by mail. You also have the option to vote in person during early voting or on election day. Applications can be downloaded at shelbyvote.com. Those absentee ballots are due no later than July 30th. You better exercise your right to vote. Momentum Men's Virtual Breakfast. We want you to get ready for Saturday, July 11th at 8 a.m. Boulevard men, join your brothers in Christ for a fun and impactful time of studying God's Word. RSVP is required and can be done using the link in e-news on Facebook or Instagram. Hey everyone, listen up. The Boulevard is looking to expand the reach of discipleship by creating new life groups. Call your family, call your friends and your neighbors, and even your coworkers. Gather them virtually to study God's Word together. No experience is required. Training and ongoing support will be provided. Anyone interested in hosting a group of 3 to 12 people through a study should contact Reverend Angel Johnson today at johnson.angel@theboulevard.org. Boulevard, we want you to tune in every Wednesday at noon in July for Boulevard Manna Moments. Come get fed on bite-sized lessons from God's Word as you move about your day. That's happening Wednesdays at noon. Calling all children, kindergarten through fifth grade, we want you to join us for Disciple Town Virtual Worship every Sunday at 12:30 p.m. on Zoom using the link in e-news. All middle, high school, and college students are highly encouraged to tune in every Sunday at 12 p.m. for the Nexus Pod. That's the place of discipleship. It's going down on Instagram Live, so follow the Nexus Boulevard Youth today on Instagram. And speaking of worship, don't forget, you have 2 opportunities to worship with us every Sunday. We want you to join us Sundays at 10:30 a.m. and 4 p.m. on Facebook Live or YouTube as we make a joyful noise across the airwaves and into homes around the world. Invite people to join you for virtual service through a watch party. Download and share the graphic and e-news and use the hashtag Boulevard Connect so people can join in on this awesome, awesome worship experience. The church buildings may still be closed, but the Boulevard is still living out the gospel of Jesus Christ because of your giving. Just last month, we were able to provide over 29,000 meals to those in need. We were also able to provide over 1,200 ready-made meals for some of our seniors in assisted living and frontline medical workers as they tirelessly work to fight the COVID-19 pandemic. This wouldn't be possible without you. There are multiple ways to give. Text Boulevard Midtown to 77977. You can cash app the Boulevard at $Mississippi Boulevard, PayPal, or by mail. Your giving makes the difference. Keep up with all the latest happenings and updates. Go to our e-news as well as our social media posts on Facebook and Instagram. Use the hashtag Boulevard Connect as you're watching from home. Show us your worship space. Take a picture of your family at church, share how you are using the devotionals, and more. Let's stay connected, y'all. Don't forget to register for Right Now Media, our digital resource library for life groups. Simply text Right Now, the Boulevard, to 41411, or use the web link in e-news to gain access to thousands of free studies for your group.
Greetings and welcome to the Mississippi Boulevard Christian Church. We're so glad that you have joined us this Sunday. Based on Ephesians 3:20, we are a church leading, learning, living, and loving without limits. Thank you for joining us for this time of worship. If you happen to be viewing this service via Facebook Live, we would like for you to share with your friends, your family, host a watch party, inviting your friends and families to fellowship with us in this worship experience. And if you happen to be viewing this from the MBCC YouTube channel, click the bell to subscribe. We would like to stay connected with you, so please email us at info@theboulevard.org and or visit our website at www.theboulevard.org. Again, welcome and enjoy our worship experience.
Let us go to God in prayer. Holy God, we thank you for being the God that you are. God, we thank you for sitting high and looking low. God, thank you for hiding us in the shadow of your wings. God, as we prepare to continue in worship on today, God, we just want to lay all of our cares and our concerns, God, even our joys at your feet, because you are a God that continues to show up for us in more ways than we can count. God, you even gave the ultimate sacrifice of your Son, who came to this earth, God, who lived here, who did ministry, God, who died for us, God, and even overcame the grave to give us the hope of an eternity with you. So God, I pray that anybody under the sound of my voice as I pray this morning, God, will be blessed and touched by your Spirit. God, that every need will be attended to. God, healing, provision, sustainment, and protection will overtake them. God, I pray for our pastor as he emits the word that you've given to him. I pray, God, that it is transformative, that your truth goes out beyond the nations, God, that we as your people will be better than we were before the service started. Now, God, we thank you in advance for all the things that you're going to do. God, we thank you for the people that will come to hear your voice and claim you as Lord and Savior. We thank you, God, for all the ways you'll make and all the things you'll do to move us forward even in this time. We love you, we honor you, and we thank you on today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning and greetings to Reverend Dr. J. Lawrence Turner and the entire MBCC Congregation of Memphis, Tennessee. It is indeed a joy and an honor to worship with you all. I am Miranda Curtis. Thank you so much for allowing me to worship with you all this morning. The reality is, the fact is that none compares to our God. No one is like him in the earth. He's amazing. Oh, yes, he is. Oh, God. Right here. Oh, Lord. Ah, Lord. How excellent is your Your name is strength. Your name is power. A strong tower makes me safe. Say it again. Oh, Lord. Ah, Lord. How excellent is your name. Your name is power. A strong tower makes me safe. Oh, oh, oh. Nobody like you, Lord. Nobody like you, Lord. Oh, 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 oh. Excellent is your name. Your name is strength. Your name is power. Strong tower makes me safe. Oh, Lord, ah, Lord, how excellent is your name. Your name is strength. Your name is power. A strong tower makes me safe. Oh, there's no. You are a healer. You are a healer.
From the inside.
is for you to be glorified, you to be lifted high. All I want is for you, you to be glorified, for you to be lifted high.
Speaks from eternity. You are.
Well, this Lord's Day, we are continuing our series, Uncharted, Navigating the Next Normal. And if you haven't figured it out by now, we're taking a journey through the life of Abraham, or Abram as he is so named now. And I want you to meet me in Genesis chapter 14. In Genesis chapter 14, we find our text for today. I want you in your quiet moments to read this chapter in entirety, because it does constitute the context of which we shall teach and preach on today. But due to the length of the passage and the limitations on our time, I just want to read verses 12 through 16 of Genesis chapter 14, and it reads this way. They also took Lot, the son of Abram's brother, who was dwelling in Sodom, and his possessions, and went their way. Then one who had escaped came and told Abram, the Hebrew, who was living by the oaks of Mamre, the Amorite, brother of Eshcol and of Aner. These were allies of Abram. Then Abram heard that his kinsmen had been taken captive. He led forth his trained men born in his house, 318 of them, and went in pursuit as far as Dan. And he divided his forces against them by night, he and his servants, and defeated them and pursued them to Hobah north of Damascus. Then he brought back all the possessions and also brought back his kinsman Lot with his possessions and the women and the people. I want to talk about saving the family, saving the family. You can comment in the comment section as we share God's word on today. When chapter 13 comes to a close, its after tension is resolved between Abram and his nephew Lot. If you recall, when they return from Egypt, they are more prosperous than they were when they initially entered into the promised land. As a consequence, upon their return, Canaan had not as of yet recovered from the famine, and the land could not sustain both of their flocks and fortunes. Thus, there was tension and conflict between their herdsmen. Abram takes the high road and allow his nephew, Lot, to choose what portion of the land that he wants. Lot chooses a portion of land that appears at the time to be fruitful and favorable, although he was moving near the enticements of Sodom. He moves near the lifeless Dead Sea, and he goes to the lowest place on earth. Abram is left with what God had promised him, and he settles for the first time in a city that is named Hebron, which in modern times is named where he builds a third altar and worships God. Whereas Lot's decision will prove one that will meet with a damning fate, this narrative will continue to show us the fruit of Abram's faith. Chapter 14 opens with an international conflict on the horizon. In short, the five kings of the cities of the plain, which included Sodom and Gomorrah, are in conflict with four kings from the east who were exerting their military might in order to secure their trade routes with Egypt. The result of their military advance is recorded in verse 11. So the enemy took all the possessions of Sodom and Gomorrah and all their provisions and went their way. That is literally the conclusion of the matter, but the author here adds an all-important footnote just in case we missed what was implied and who was included in the spoils of war taken from Sodom and Gomorrah. When in verse 12 it says, they also took Lot, the son of Abram's brother, who was dwelling in Sodom, and his possessions, and went their way. Get the picture. God had brought Abram and his nephew Lot into uncharted territory, the promised land. And yet, as it relates to Abram, he lost his family to the land. And I want to be clear, this is no fault of Abram's own. Lot had become enticed by the commercialism and materialism of Sodom and decided to live there. He was enamored by what the old Kanye West would call flashing lights. He finds himself in a dead end of a situation, lower than he'd ever been before. As a result of his poor decisions, Lot ends up a casualty of war. But Abram, in a real sense, has lost his family to the land. And I think I need to speak to someone today who is responsible for your family. Some mother or father, whether both parents are in the home or whether it's a single parent home, you find yourself just like Abram. You have brought your family into the place of promise. Your hopes have become your reality. Your ancestors' wildest dreams have been realized, but now it's become a nightmare unfolding as it relates to your family. Your children and grandchildren are ungrateful for what God has blessed your family to live into. They're attending schools that you never would imagine going to. They're living in houses that you could have only dreamed of living in. They have clothes that you couldn't afford while you were growing up, made by designers that you could not pronounce their name. And just like Lot was in the land but had drifted from the Lord, your children have no sense of God's voice and presence in their own lives. And some of this parents must take personal responsibility for, spoiling and appeasing children who have no appreciation for what God has done in your life and what you have labored diligently to bring to pass. But the rest of it has come as a result of poor decisions that children have made. They've been trained up in the way that they should go, and now they're old. They've decided to go their own way and depart from the ways they've been taught. What has happened is that you have, like Abram, lost your family to the land. And if I could remix the words of the Savior to his disciples and ask, what does it profit a man or a woman to gain the whole world and lose their family? I want us to look at the life of Abram, who, when Lot is taken away, is intentional about saving his family. Abram first teaches us that there are some things in life that are worth fighting for. Verse 13 informs us that after Lot and his family were taken away by the enemy, one person escapes and came to Abram, the Hebrew, who was living by the oaks of Mamre. Don't read over this too fast. When this person who brought Abram the message of Lot being taken away, he finds Abram by the oaks of Mamre. Mamre means fatness or richness. I would suggest that not only does this describe Abram's place geographically, but it's where he is financially. Life is good for Abram. He's at a place in life where many of us would have just sailed into the sunset, but we don't see that here when he hears that his family is in trouble. The text teaches us that he went into action to save his family. What drove this decision is written in plain sight in the text. The text refers to Abram as Abram the Hebrew. Hebrew is a word that literally means all the world was on one side and he was on the other side. It speaks of one who is diametrically opposed to the value system of the world that places materialism over what's meaningful. It places prosperity over people. And what it teaches us about Abram is that he lived in such a way and had such a worldview that was shaped by a faith that places worth and value on one's family. We must be like Abram. We cannot cling to the riches of this world while leaving our families to the wiles of the devil and this world. Psalm 127:3 teaches us, behold, children are a heritage from the Lord, the fruit of the womb, a reward. This is suggesting that true wealth and blessedness is to receive the gift of family as a gift from God. And whenever you receive a gift from God, you should cherish it, protect it, cultivate it, defend it, and be willing to put oneself on the line for it. Because while we may think our families belong to us, they have ultimately been entrusted to us by God. And I believe if God has given you something so valuable, such as family, it's something worth fighting for. If your marriage is in trouble, fight for it. If your children are off track, fight to get them back on track. Don't go through life knowing the price of everything, but not the value of anything that matters. I must submit to you that it was not only Abram's value system that moved him into action, but it was also his faith in God's word. When you go back to chapter 12, recall that God told Abram, go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and him who dishonors you, I will curse. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. God made Abram a promise that not only will the land belong to him, but his descendants would dwell in the land as well. When Lot is taken away, there was no Isaac. There was no Ishmael born as of yet. Abram's family beyond his wife Sarai was his nephew Lot. So in that moment, Abram trusted God's word is going to come to pass, and his participation in what God would ultimately do is to save Lot from captivity. Literally, Abram's faith is based on the word of the Lord. There's going to come a time in all of our lives where all that we have is a word from God. There's always competing voices trying to sway you one way or another, but you have to ask the question that Isaiah asked, whose report will you believe? Then go ahead and respond to your own question and say, I will believe the report of the Lord. Our faith is not empty rhetoric, and it's not just optimism. It is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. God's promises and the word give us confidence that no matter how broken this world is and how bleak the outlook may become, and no matter how bad off my family may be, I know that God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. All of the promises of God are yes and amen. All that goes to show us is that if God has made you a promise, God is invested in seeing the promise all the way through to fulfillment. Any of you who bought a home in recent years know that one of the best protections for your investment is not only homeowner's insurance, but a home warranty that protects many of the appliances that allow your home to function. I can recall that a ceiling fan in my home stopped working, and I didn't think that it was covered, that it was significant enough. However, my wife read through the legalese and discovered that although the ceiling fan was not a dishwasher or air conditioning unit, it was included in the agreement. So when we called the company for this request for repair of the ceiling fan, the company that serviced the agreement had to honor the call because it was in the agreement. Literally, they had given us their word that they would take care of these things. That's the confidence given to Abram and that we should have, that if it's in the word, we can trust that God is going to fulfill what he has promised. The songwriter put it this way, God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's going to fulfill every promise he's made to you. Don't give up on God because he won't give up on you, because God is able to fulfill his word. But I want you to note that Abram's faith is not only to fight for what matters most and based on the word of God, but it is a faith that through his example teaches us that when you fight, take the best that you have. Note that Lot has been taken captive by the armies of four kings. One would think if Abram is going to rescue Lot and save his family, that it would take an alliance with other armies in order to have victory. But we learn in verse 14, when Abram heard that his kinsmen had been taken captive, he led forth his trained men born in his house, 318 of them, and went in pursuit as far as Dan. Abram takes 318 men to fight against four armies. Clearly, the numbers are against him. He seems to be outmatched, but note that the text says that these 318 were trained men born in his house. When it says that they were trained men, it is to suggest that they were skilled for battle. And when it says that they were born in his house, it suggests that they were loyal to him. All of that taken into consideration, 318 is all that he had, but it was the best that he had. And in addition to taking the best that he had into battle, it didn't hurt to have God on his side. I believe what Abram's success in saving his family against all odds is that he took the best that he had and left the rest up to God. This is a word to someone whose family has been taken captive, some spouse who has found their spouse captivated with attraction to someone else. It's a word to a parent whose child or children have been taken captive by the streets or by drugs or even by low self-esteem. God is declaring to you, be like Abram and use what you have and the best that you have. You might not think that it's much, but when you take the best that you have with faith in God, God can give you victory in recovering that which you have lost. Faith is so important because God is requiring you not to just use the best of what you have and give the best effort that you can and at your limits allow God to take over. When you let God take over, you'll discover that God plus one is a majority any way you count it. Don't sit by in passive resignation to what's happened. Do what you can. Use what you have. And when you've come to the end of your rope, tie a knot and hang in there. God will come through on your behalf. We don't do this just because this is what Abram did. This is what Jesus did for every one of us. You and I were lost. We had a hell-bound destiny, But God loved us so much. He wouldn't leave us hanging in the wind. He wouldn't leave us to our own devices. But God loved us so much that he sent the best that he had in the person of Jesus Christ to take our place on the cross and to give you and I eternal life where we can spend eternity with Jesus Christ. The part I love about it is not only about how we can spend eternity with Jesus, he wants to take a closer walk with you on today. And so I want to issue a challenge to somebody today, some parent, some spouse, someone who's thinking about starting a family, that if God has given you something as valuable as a family, you ought to fight for it. You ought to be living to put your life on the line for it, not because simply of what Abraham or Abram models for us, but because that's the way God loves us. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son so that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. If you're watching this broadcast on today, I want to offer Jesus Christ to you. He'll give you a brand new life. He'll give you a new lease on life. He wants a relationship with you right here on earth. And he wants to spend eternity with you. But Jesus is not going to force himself on any of us. He wants you to open up the door to your heart and let him in. And I guarantee if you let Jesus Christ in, he'll make the difference in your life. And so if you want to respond to the love that God has for you, I want you to send me an email right now to connect@theboulevard.org. Just send an email and say, I want to give my life to Jesus Christ. And our team is going to be in touch with you to help you with the decision that you're making on today. And then if you're here watching this stream today and you're already saved, but you're not connected to a church family. And I know it's odd in this season of physical distancing where we can't gather for corporate worship. I know it's odd to invite someone to become part of a church, but we've understood during these times that the church is more than just a building. And if you want to be a part of what God is doing through the life of Mississippi Boulevard Christian Church, we want you to send us an email to connect@theboulevard.org and just let people know that you want to become part of our church, and our team is going to be in touch with you to assist you with the decision that you're making today. I guarantee you, if the Lord is moving upon you to make a decision on today, don't hesitate. Don't wait. You send an email right now to do what God is calling you to do in this moment. Well, my brothers and my sister, it's been awesome to come into your homes as we worship God in the midst of this holiday weekend. And I hope that God has continued to minister to you. God has continued to take care of you. You had an opportunity to get some rest and have a little fun on this weekend. I am so excited that we continue to share and further the ministry that God has given us through our various platforms. We want you back here every Sunday, 10:30 a.m. or 4 p.m. for our worship experiences online. Well, as we come to the end of this time, I want to bless you. As we continue in the rest of this day, I pray that God would continue to walk with you and talk with you, that you would make time this week to make sure that you are saving your family from what the world might be causing you to compete with. Get ready to receive this blessing even in your home. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace in your labor and in your leisure, in your laughter, in your tears, until we shall see Jesus face to face. And we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful rest of this Sunday.
That happened on your mind. You got some situations and you're running out of time. There's one who has the answer. Give it over to him. Give it up and let it go and praise your way through. Yeah.
You can praise your way. You can praise your way through.
You can praise your way through.
You can praise your way. You can praise your way through.
Through every storm, yeah.
You can praise your way.
Why can't it stop today? Go on and go through and remember his promise to you. Take your hands off, throw your hands up, and praise your way through.
You can praise your way. You can praise your way through.
You can praise your way through. Whoa, whoa.
You can praise your way. You can praise your way through.
What's happening, Boulevard family? I'm Jeremy Pierre. This is your video announcements. We need you to pay very close attention to stay up on what's happening here at the Boulevard. Let's get it. If you are a registered voter and do not wish to vote in person due to the COVID-19 situation, you are eligible to request an absentee ballot by mail. You also have the option to vote in person during early voting or on election day. Applications can be downloaded at shelbyvote.com. Those absentee ballots are due no later than July 30th. You better exercise your right to vote. Momentum Men's Virtual Breakfast. We want you to get ready for Saturday, July 11th at 8 a.m. Boulevard men, join your brothers in Christ for a fun and impactful time of studying God's Word. RSVP is required and can be done using the link in e-news on Facebook or Instagram. Hey everyone, listen up. The Boulevard is looking to expand the reach of discipleship by creating new life groups. Call your family, call your friends and your neighbors, and even your coworkers. Gather them virtually to study God's word together. No experience is required. Training and ongoing support will be provided. Anyone interested in hosting a group of 3 to 12 people through a study should contact Reverend Angel Johnson today at johnson.angel@theboulevard.org. Boulevard, we want you to tune in every Wednesday at noon in July for Boulevard Manna Moments. Come get fed on bite-sized lessons from God's Word as you move about your day. That's happening Wednesdays at noon. Calling all children, kindergarten through 5th grade, we want you to join us for Disciple Town virtual worship every Sunday at 12:30 p.m. on Zoom using the link in eNews. All middle, high school, and college students are highly encouraged to tune in every Sunday at 12 p.m. for the Nexus Pod. That's the place of discipleship. It's going down on Instagram Live, so follow the Nexus Boulevard Youth today on Instagram. And speaking of worship, don't forget, you have 2 opportunities to worship with us every Sunday. We want you to join us Sundays at 10:30 a.m. and 4 p.m. on Facebook Live or YouTube as we make a joyful noise across the airwaves and into homes around the world. Invite people to join you for virtual service through a watch party. Download and share the graphic and e-news and use the hashtag Boulevard Connect so people can join in on this awesome, awesome worship experience. The church buildings may still be closed, but the Boulevard is still living out the gospel of Jesus Christ because of your giving. Just last month, we were able to provide over 29,000 meals to those in need. We were also able to provide over 1,200 ready-made meals for some of our seniors in assisted living and frontline medical workers as they tirelessly work to fight the COVID-19 pandemic. This wouldn't be possible without you. There are multiple ways to give. Text Boulevard Midtown to 77977. You can cash app the Boulevard at $Mississippi Boulevard, PayPal, or by mail. Your giving makes the difference. Keep up with all the latest happenings and updates. Go to our e-news as well as our social media posts on Facebook and Instagram. Use the hashtag Boulevard Connect as you're watching from home. Show us your worship space. Take a picture of your family at church. Share how you are using the devotionals and more. Let's stay connected, y'all. Don't forget to register for Right Now Media, our digital resource library for life groups. Simply text Right Now, the Boulevard, to 41411 or use the web link in eNews to gain access to thousands of free studies for your group.